What's up, guys? So I just got a quick little video today. We're going to be talking about the updates. I'm just going to kind of briefly talk about them. We don't have to go in full in-depth. So obviously, you can pause right now and take a look, or you can just look on the forums, look on the Discord. I'll have the link in the description below. But basically, the main things we're trying to do is just get some of those things fixed. I'll talk about some of the bigger changes. The donator zone should now be accessible. It's based on your amount spent. So for anybody who has the zone, we're still working on the ranks and the yells and everything like that. That's just a little bit of a bigger issue, so we couldn't get that in this patch. Fixed a couple minor issues, just random things like that. There is now a free cape players can claim, the Cape of Masters. It's this cape right here. It has the stats of a skill cape with one strength bonus. So, yeah, it's not bad. It's not amazing or anything. You know, if you're doing something like something melee specific, you'd probably still want to use your fire cape. But, and it also has negative weight bonus. So I should have negative. Well, I guess if I banked my my food. Yeah, there we go. Negative bonus. Yeah, and I realize this is kind of a spoiler for my account, seeing all these things and recording this video. But I don't know. Sorry for the spoilers. Another update is Crombon fishing. The Crombon vessel is in the Adventure Point shop. So you can now do this right here. And I guess that's about it for the updates. The main thing I want to talk about for this video is sort of the future. I meant to do this video before the server even came out, but I just didn't have time to get around to it. Things that we, you know, I didn't want to delay this actual server updates or anything like that just to get this video out. I figured we could do it now. So let's do it now. Okay, so this is the roadmap. This is the plan for basically the next 2 or 3 months. Just kind of depends on how things go. Now, these are the sort of bigger updates that we're talking about, or the more important things, and I'll sort of go down the list from there. Along the way, there will obviously be a lot of updates, and as I've even added here, bug fixes, just smaller stuff that'll kind of be what people suggest, things that make sense, things that are easy to do, things that we like, stuff like that, that, you know, is just too small to could be considered in this roadmap. So just don't think that this is the only things that are going to be happening. So we'll start off with the big one, invention skill. This is obviously one of the big things that we decided to keep from Revival 1. It is important. We do plan to have that out very soon. It is Dark's priority. He's been working on that. So we will have that out. It will be roughly similar to Revival 1, but obviously, you know, we have the chance to make improvements and learn from our past mistakes. And, you know, so hopefully it should be a lot better. But that is one of, that is his priority, and that is something we hope to have out soon. Gauntlet and Zalcano are part of home. Those are just kind of really important things for Priftus being our home. It just makes a lot of sense. Gauntlet is also a nice bit of content. It should introduce Bofa, which is a very powerful thing. And it also should give people more reasons to collect crystal shards and stuff like that, and earn them as well. So that should be a lot of fun. I don't actually know anything about Zalcano, but I'm really interested to learn. That might be something I try to do myself, just to sort of get my feet wet with that kind of content. Donator zone improvements. If you've seen the donator zone, you'll know that it doesn't have a whole lot right now. We decided to go with just one zone, and our plan is, it's kind of big. It's Miscellanea and the dungeon below it, and kind of the surrounding areas is what we're going to use. So the plan is to sort of just, you know, have the one zone for all ranks, but then have just kind of certain areas that are locked off, or certain, like, oh, this teleporter is only used by higher ranks and stuff like that. So it should be a lot easier than having to, you know, balance out and make 7 zones, or, you know, however many zones we had on the last server. You know, we can just focus on one, and a lot of the things were kind of repetitive. It's like, oh, okay, well, we have to add the Orb of Light to all of them to make it fast. We have to add an altar. We have to add that cave thingy. So this should avoid that and should make things a lot easier. And it is really important that we add a lot of improvements to it. I think that's one thing we've always suffered from on my servers. I don't think the D-Zone has ever been worth getting. I know that that's kind of been by design, right? We didn't want, you know, I didn't want people to feel that way, but also it kind of loses its appeal. It loses the fun of it existing in the first place if it's not special. So we definitely need to make a lot of improvements in there, and that's why I put it under priority updates, because I wanted to make sure that people knew that that's something we take seriously, and I do want to improve a lot of things about that. As far as Revival Classic goes, just want to finish up adding all the rest of the accounts that are missing, and then finish handing the Luck of the Chow, so then we can at least consider Revival Classic done for a little while. Well, I'll talk about that in a second, in a little minute. So then, as far as like future updates that are going to be a little bit more down the road, we have God Wars 2, and God Wars 2 is going to be a little bit different than Revival 1's version. I'm going to do probably different gods. I might reuse certain items or stuff like that, reuse locations, but for the most part, it's going to be different. And the logic behind it is, I like to think of every private server and every version of RuneScape, RuneScape 3, old school RS, and even Classic back in the day, I like to think of them as different universes. And so, like, just every other private server, Lazo's server, whatever, is just a different parallel universe. And I like to think of Revival 2 and Revival 1 being, you know, parallel universes as well. So that's kind of the logic and why it's going to be a little bit different. I know most people don't care about lore and stuff like that, but I like lore. So I'll definitely try to make it interesting, and I'm very excited to do it differently than before. So it will be unique content, but it is kind of similar to the Revival 2 from last server. And I really hope that we can get Revival 3 out as well. I didn't want to just do Revival 3 on here and then, like, there's no Revival 2. It's on Classic. We'll just do both. And we really, really got to get Revival 3 down the road. I should put future updates and have Revival 3 is the only thing in that section. But next up is Mercenaries. This is going to be the first big, unique thing. Because, like, all of the rest of the things are things you've seen before. God Wars 2 will be a little bit unique, but for the most part, you've seen the concept. You can get a rough idea of what we're going to do. Invention skill, same thing. It's going to be a little bit different, but for the most part, you know what you're expecting. Gauntlet and Zalcano are already old school things. We might end up doing it a little custom, but for the most part, it's just old school content. It's not unique. Mercenaries will be the big first idea. I'm not going to talk about it too much here because, you know, it is a future update. You'll probably hear more about it down the road, but and then sometime soon, I don't want to say when, I'm thinking it'll probably, like, obviously July 4th is the next big holiday, but I think we'll probably do a player appreciation event, our first one before then. So that's probably what this will be. I'm expecting it to be probably late May, early June-ish. Or maybe we'll just call it a summer event or something like that. And then more perks for Masters and Knights. I want there to be more of a reason to play these modes, as, you know, a lot of people right now have kind of had the mindset it's not worth it to play the higher modes. There are actually additional benefits. As I mentioned in the update portion, you now have this cape, which I know it isn't amazing. It isn't diehard. It's going to have more perks than what it has right now. I wanted to get a base cape out there so people had it. Honestly, I wanted it for myself to play. I won't lie. That's usually a lot about how a lot of updates come. But there are additional perks along the way. It's kind of hard to show you, but if I go to the drop table and then, like, I show you monster. Let's look at Abyssal Demon. It's perfect. So right here you can see the chance for a whip is 1 in 209. And you can see that, if we go back, you can see that I am a master. So let's log in on my other account. So we're on the other account. And we can see that this one is an initiate. And if we go to drop tables and then we go to Abyssal Demon, we look at whip, the chance is 1 in 232. So you can see that masters do have an improved drop rate. The exact rate might be tweaked. And at the moment, masters do not have a boost. Masters are supposed to have a boost. It's just going to be less than the one that masters get. So, did I say master twice? I meant knights, if I said master twice. Knights are supposed to get the boost that masters get. And that's not currently coded, but there will be that. And again, we want more additional perks. And so then the last thing we'll talk about is the Revival Classic updates. We have, obviously, we're going to do some more bug fixes, some of the things that some people have reported. Quality of life changes, some of the improvements. I think we'll probably start reverting back the boxes to the way that they originally were. I think that that's what a lot of people liked. And then we'll probably do a new event same time as the Revival 2 event. We'll probably sort of tie them in together. As far as what happens from there, if there's any, like, unique custom updates, I'd like to do them. But again, if there's no time, if we're spending a lot of time 1 week to devote to Classic and it's only for, like, one or two players, it's kind of hard to justify that. So it just depends on the amount of players that like it, the amount of players that are supporting it, the amount of players that care about it. But I do still want to, you know, I don't want to forget about it. I want it to be something that, you know, that we try to keep around for the people that do like it. But that's going to do it for this video. If you have any suggestions, questions, bug reports, anything like that, love to hear from you. All the links you need will be in the description below. Thanks for watching.